But we have to find
Lily, you want she's going to
from your
maybe we can just all share the questions because we're also not really aware. So
yeah. Also, who feels inspired?
I don't know how this happens.
We would need a representative from you, from the elder one, from maybe from all the regions. Maybe people from South are. So, what we have to think is one important thing when we do it is we have to believe it. And then we had all different kind of numbers. Mm-hmm. And if it, somebody wanted lower than 100,000, but they don't believe 100, or else they would have said 100. So, then we do a goal that we know everyone believes. So, and don't worry, you know, as we are going, the goals, we can adjust the goals, we can review and we can adjust. So the important thing is that we send the same goal to that target point. So if everyone believe at least we will make 80,000, then we do that. But if we say 100,000, not everyone believes that, you know. So we have to believe what we are doing unanimously and take it from there. So in your own time at home, and when you are with yourself and can center yourself more, then you can, however you do it, get into that penthouse and we'll be there. And then you just do it.
Yeah.
That's all. Mm-hmm. Thank you, with this. Mm-hmm. I am inspired. I have to tell you about the meeting. I'm from Germany and we are not so easy to be in tears.
To what? Not be in tears.
Different spirit, like Italian spirit, French spirit. I was sleeping in French spirit, then Irish spirit, and it was the Austrian spirit, of course. I am always drawn to the Austrian corner. And there was the Ukrainian, very quiet. I would like to ask somebody from the Ukrainian sisters to say also how they felt here with all these West Europeans, North Europeans, South Europeans, like such a mixture. Like Lily said, how many nations are we here? I don't know. 25 people and 20 nations. There's more from Austria, more from Italy, but all the others are really...
Would be good to list all the countries.
Yeah, also, is there somebody?
We have a list.
We have a list from the...
Then tell us how many we are.
We have even Africa here. We have not only Europe here.
Latin America.
Exactly.
Yeah. We have all the legislation.
In Maryland said 76 yesterday.
Uh-huh.
76.
Yeah.
I hope the Women's Federation appears on the OIME or on the... Should not? Not? But at least we will receive the pictures.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I live in the diaspora, we live in the diaspora Bavaria, far away from all the...
It's the belly button of the world.
Ah, yeah. 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 We feel as we are really the middle...
The European side.
And we have in March our national gathering. All the Germans will meet there. We have to do like election again, like if I should go or if somebody else wants to take my chair. I'm always ready to. I like news. I brought some news. So this is the future, and this gives me energy. And my son was also in the blessing in Korea. I was not there, but you were there. But I saw the nice pictures. And we support our young couple. We support all the couples, all the young second gen.
Kyung-In
is ready. Please then come.
Yes. As I'm on the program. So, yes, dear sisters, I think it's very lovely to meet here in Italy. First of all, thank you so much for the great take care of us here in Colle Mattia. I have never been here. And yeah, I think the build up of the sessions were very nice themes, also very informative, very impressive what all the chapters are doing, all the regions. So it was really nice to hear about that. And also the overview, then session two with the three global themes. It was quite clear also. And I also really enjoyed the brainstorming sessions. I hope you all had quite some inspirational discussions. I kind of missed what we're gonna, if we're going to do something with that, or will there be some follow-up on that, aside of that we have our own inspiration. That's a question maybe for later. And also the youth session, yes, I was also there. Yes, we want to work on that, so I think step by step we'll get some follow-up from the young professionals as well. And I think we're going to work also with the ladies who were in Cyprus still, so there will be some follow-ups. Yes, nice to see some sisters again, if we didn't see a long time. And Europe all together. So I feel that, yeah, True Mother is very, very happy that we're here. I'm sure she's with us in heart and spirit. And I think she's very grateful for all you ladies investing all your lives, basically, or starting to invest. And also a big thank you to Ms. Rizzi for a great entertainment yesterday. And yeah, for the financial update, it's nice. I really enjoyed. Thank you so much, Vikas, also your inspirational manifesting talk. Yes. So I hope it's also not super clear to me how we're gonna raise it, but probably we will have some updates on that too. So thank you so much, sisters. And yeah, that's a question from my side. Maybe somebody can answer what we're gonna do with the brainstorm outcome of the session two of the global things.
Thank you. Thank you, Kyung-In. And my question is also now again, last chance. Who wants to say some conclusions?
Questions?
Yeah.
I was just thinking about the reports because there are so many and very interesting things. Would it be possible to make them available to us, like to view them?
Yeah.
You know, take some time and view the reports.
You have all the reports. Can you put them in the Google Drive with the pictures?
Yeah, and Shafna asked for copies of them all too.
Are you talking about the PowerPoint?
Yes.
What we were discussing, the three topics, these outcomes, I think.
Yeah,
it would be nice to have some
send us what
information
we'll put them in.
Compact. Because in our German meeting, we want to give also a report about our European level, because it's not so easy to win the hearts of the members in Germany, for example, for the European level, that we should pay also something.
Yeah.
And also, we want to invite more young sisters, young ladies, guests, friends, and they are interested in national. The Ukrainians are, we have many Ukrainian women, mothers in Germany, they will come. They are interested in how to support Ukraine from Germany. So they want to fundraise with their products in Germany. They have actually greenbacks like this. green t-shirts, they have small wooden owls,
owls.
Owls, yeah, they have many products I should sell, or I should find ways, they would find ways. So we are also in the process of making money. Maya.
Yes, I want to ask you to, I have a question. In Ukraine, in Russia, they cannot go on the streets and pray publicly or ask publicly for the end of the war. Over the worldwide community to help to bring the parties to the table. And I am always the Committee on Peace. Also, I am very much asked how to think peace. We were going through the money, how much money we should imagine, how much peace I can imagine in my mind. That we are all brothers and sisters and mothers, fathers and children. I learned from Slovakia, for example, that even mothers went on the and fathers went on the street. And they went from Russian to Ukrainian to White Russian embassies and also to the president of the Republic to offer the wish and the prayer that we wish in Europe to have peace. In 2014, we received Peace Nobel Prize because we could survive 70 years without fighting against
the China. European Union, this was 2012.
2012, this year from European Union. And now European Union is supporting somehow countries still fighting and not asking for communication, for speaking together. This is my concern and my desire. When we have peace, then we can send people to clean and to make stone again to bring stone to the order to build buildings again like it was the castles, the monasteries, the old culture in these countries exist or whatever existed there. Yeah? The fabrics where Russia was were preparing something they can be accepted on a worldwide level. So this is my question, like neutral country, Austria, I listen to many reports, how much we can invite people to talk, but even Austrian ambassador told me, they are not ready. So who? Whom hearts? Mother's heart, we give birth to the children. So we wish that they stay alive, they can see peaceful reunification and forgiveness, and I can say sorry when somebody is attacking, somebody who needs to attack, even in the families, when some children are very upset. So we hug them and we ask, what happened to you? Why are you so upset? So this method, I don't know if we can do it outside of fighting countries, like free human beings. This free desire for peace and for stopping of destruction of houses, of families, of killing the husbands and brothers and children and even surroundment. We were talking, our discussion group was about surroundment, how to clean water, clean surroundment, happiness, how we can create happiness. And this is my question or my desire, how we can support this process, how can we do it from our free world position. Thank you.
Thank you.
In Central Region, for example, we have the regular prayer meeting.
Yeah.
Because Ukraine belongs to Central Region. Yeah. So also the Women Federation, many of us, they always regularly meet on Zoom, and
yes.
Also we join this prayer condition. And some are doing extra condition. So this is the question maybe to all the women and mothers, like Maya said. In Germany we have prayer points. We follow these prayer points because we are like Team Germany. Our leader says, I cannot carry it alone. I need a team because he is working full time and he carries
But are you talking about Women's Federation?
Yeah, I mean, in Germany they are a team, we are a team, and we are also a team, you said yesterday. Yeah, so maybe it's possible we have a pre-condition together on European level, or you could join this European condition.
I think we need to focus on Women's Federation.
Germany or to Poland or to Romania or to Moldavia or to Hungary or Slovakia, or if they stay in country, they need to follow.
Yeah, we received the reports from Anna.
Yeah,
I received everybody like on the central regional level and OIME level receives the reports, and she even sends WhatsApp message if there is again error, like she wrote. Right after the blessing, they had to go to the basement. They could watch their own captain. There was Ukrainian still also there. And
after the question, they
do something
to write letter, for example, to the embassies. To write letters. Then we are accepted, like because of the United Nations accredited organization. If we can write a letter substantial to the outside embassies. I wrote a letter to American embassy, like chair of Committee on Peace, when I heard that, that America and European Union are ready to bring cluster bomb to Ukraine. So I went through this on the Balkan region. My husband and me, we supported the consequences of this. So it takes years to find these bombs into the earth. So you cannot put any cement inside nothing. You need to bring people, they purify, the special instruments.
It's a difficult situation.
It's very difficult.
And I can see in UN Vienna or Geneva, they have other topics.
Yeah.
We know now that your mother wants to go to UN in Geneva. In May,
we have to support her to Geneva.
She wants to come. And afterwards to other countries. It was said in the German leaders meeting.
So okay.
I don't know if it is clear. Geneva. In Switzerland, she wants to start.
That was a proposal, a very concrete proposal from the leaders meeting, but it wasn't accepted.
So this is still discussed. We should be free in May.
Michael went to Michael Balcom went to Korea and talked with the international headquarters and mother's schedule is decided. She's arriving May 3rd, leaving the 24th. She's starting in Prague. Then she goes to Slovakia. She won't go to Hamburg though because it's too small. We'll have to do it at another location. But that's when all the membership can see her and spend time.
So nice. This is really nice. This is the last.
That's mother's schedule.
I only know the German side from 2 weeks ago. So
that's
this is
right.
The new
update. Yeah, that's what
update. Okay. Thank you very much. So then
I forgot a very important point. Oh, sorry, do you want to say something about this?
I would like to also ask maybe one thing, which is also connected with what Maria said, but we have also the conflict in Israel and Palestine. And I was, when we had the international interfaith meeting together with UPF, I was somehow doing research on one organization, women organization in Israel, and this is called Women Wage Peace. Maybe you know this.
Yeah.
If we as I didn't know if we as Women's Federation, we cooperate with them in some way. I don't know.
or we can support them because they are working with Palestinian women together with Israeli women, mother, and they also working for peace in this region. So I don't know if we can support them in some way or cooperate with them.
Yeah. I attend some of their meetings. They're very, very good. Since before the war started.
Yeah, yeah.
So then Betty contacted me, and I contacted a sister because they're in Nazareth. Mm-hmm. And we have one Japanese sister in Nazareth who is now the acting national leader. Officially, she's not Women's Federation. But she contacted them, and she was the next point. She was going to visit them and have a meeting and stuff. So we're in touch with them. They have a huge network.
Yeah, they have 40,000 members, 40,000, both sides. So this is a huge organization, and they are always protesting in front of their government, Knesset, and asking to stop, you know, the genocide. But both being
and
from
they're
both.
Very, very sincere, and very professional, very artistic.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful organization. So we're trying to stay with them.
So I just came up here because I realized that I forgot an important point that I wanted to emphasize and also thank the ladies for all the hard work. That's the curriculum, actually, because we had the launch, and Lily did a lot of behind-the-scenes work, so thank you so much, Lily. And thank you so much also for emphasizing that we have to study the curriculum. Mm-hmm. I was inspired some months ago, but I didn't, so I made my personal resolution that I will study it and try to work with it as well. And also I have my resolution to also support the Lusophone countries in Africa, so I will see how I can do that. And also, actually, we're also building a UN team in Africa step by step, also in all other continents. But so is there anyone else who wants to share something?
Before I want just to speak about action step.
Okay.
Maybe some impression, or someone wants to share impression yet, you know?
I just want to really thank you actually, Mitty and Elisabeth, and each one of you who worked so hard to get this conference together, because it was a very, really, very good conference.
Mm-hmm.
It was very informative. It was so amazing to see what everybody reported, what you are doing, and also we could see also that we still have a lot to do. And that there is a lot of opening now, that if we
work
together, that we can really make something happen, especially now it's not as full and for sure coming. I wanted to say something about, when we were talking about the bridge of peace, I think it would be great if we could more emphasize that again. And definitely the 1% love sharing, if we can strengthen it and use it more. But also, for a while I had in mind one kind of theme, and it's called benevolence, not violence.
Yeah.
And I really feel it could be like a project, like a service project, if we could connect that with the Bridge of Peace ceremony. Benevolence, not violence, is very, very good slogan, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
If you could make it like a service project, connect it with the Bridge of Peace, and create partnerships with these organizations, like you mentioned, the Women in Bridge of Peace, and there are others as well that we found. Jewish Voice for Peace is very good and very interesting, really helping Palestine. And so I feel it could be a project. Benevolence, not violence. If we can initiate service projects in different countries for that title of building bridges of peace, would be great. But really, it was very moving, this conference, for me, I must say. I didn't expect it would be like that. But it was also artistically, spiritually, and informative. And I just want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
come to these meetings, I don't know exactly what we are expecting, but I felt that this meeting was very relaxing in a way, very artistic, as you said, very informative, with very good sessions, and we are able to relate to each other and go deeper in our relationships. And every time we go deeper with someone different, and that's really wonderful. I think we can learn a little bit about what each other is doing, and definitely we have not stopped, so the energy keeps moving, and we are growing from this. Of course, to have our younger team here is also beautiful, and to get to know them and have hopes for the future is very important. And I would like to thank everybody in my name and on behalf of the Women's Federation. So it's so important that we get going and we learn from each other, and that's really beautiful. Thank you everyone for your efforts, and well, we will go on and meet next time somewhere else, right?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Since I represent the Middle East, I should say something.
Yes.
Because everybody is worried about the Middle East.
Right? Yeah.
So, anyway, thank you very much. It was really wonderful being here. So happy to be back in Colle, Mattia. Very nice memories. And to be in Italy again and with my wonderful sisters. We just saw each other in Cyprus. And I was very grateful to be invited. I'm not part of the executive board, but I think it's Mitty is always thinking about how to include everybody and how to really be embracing. So I'm very grateful for that. It was wonderful, as everyone said. I just want to mention, you know, the Middle East is a very heavy place, you can imagine, right? 6,000 years of biblical history. Adam and Eve were born there. Abraham was there. Noah was there. Everybody was there, right? All the people that made all the victories and all. What?
And now Merlin.
And now So I was just thinking what I really wanted to say. Like you mentioned about this this group. It's a wonderful group. And the sister that I asked to contact them, she's now a Japanese sister, and she's the acting national leader of Israel. And the situation of Israel right now inside the movement is not the best. And she's handling all this heavy load. So I realized that when I answered you, when I kind of just said, it meant, it sounded like it's being taken care of. But it's not. So I just want to say, if any of you have an inspiration, please, you know, you can ask me, you can ask Zoe, you can ask anybody who you can contact to support and help, because
there is one Czech second gen now, Vicky Masler, she's there.
Yeah.
I don't know if they have some, like, responsibility, but maybe also through, we can involve her a little bit.
Right. But I would ask if you would go through Haruko-san before you go directly to Vicky, because Vicky tends to be extremely independent and does her own thing, even though nobody else knows it or wants it, and she has other things she should be doing. So we're a small, very small community. So everybody's doing everything. You know, I'm BFD, I'm Women's Federation, I'm the regional president's wife, you know, I'm everything. So just what I want to say is, if you have this kind of inspiration, and you just let me know, I can let you know who to contact. Mm-hmm. And it would be so wonderful if you could even just give a word of encouragement or an idea or some kind of, you know, help or inspiration or a smiley face or something to help the brothers and sisters there to fulfill their mission. If you want to send money, I mean, that would be really awesome also, you know. So, I mean, any kind of support. I always wish that we could have more support between Western or Europe and the Middle East, you know, somehow to Big Brother and little, I don't know. But, you know, we have to build that. It has to come naturally. So the situation in Gaza between Israel and Hamas is horrific. I mean, absolutely horrific. And I'm ashamed as an American because America is supporting Israel so strongly. And we have to really pray. We're liberating, thanks to the European members, we're liberating Israeli and Palestinian victims of the war. And I think that's very, very important because when you have 30,000 people that have been killed, you have incredible resentment in the spiritual world that doesn't go anywhere. And it makes it more difficult for the people on earth to forgive. So this is, you know, and plus you have the, what, 60 million people that were killed in the Holocaust. So this is the kind of spirit world we're dealing with. So we need a lot of prayer and as any support that's possible. But I really hope, I'm sure you're praying. I know you're praying. And also, Mother assigned certain people, I think you probably know this, Mother asked certain people to pray for 40 days every single day in the Junction 1 for Ukraine and Russia situation and also Israel and Hamas. So this particular sister, no, not this, Hod Bensby's wife is praying every day in the Junction 1 and my husband also for Israel and Hamas. So we hope something can happen. We really pray that there can be some breakthrough. But as we all know, reconciliation is really the problem. So this bridge of peace, you're absolutely right. We need to do this more and more. But right now, they can't even look at each other. There's so much hate and so much resentment. You know? So this is the kind of thing that we need to really try to alleviate. Anyways, Mother expects us to solve the problems of the world. This is what she's looking for. And we have to begin with prayer, but also we have to move forward and make solutions. So anything that we can do, I think, is very important. I'm sorry, I don't want to end on it. It's, things are changing. We have True Mother, and, you know, we're marching forward, right? Yeah. We're moving forward in 2024, and we're going to bring great victory.
Yes.
All of you have the deepest heart. How many tears do we shed in these? This is supposed to be a like a business conference, right? And here we are crying and crying. So this means that we're changing and we're becoming the people that really Mother needs. So let's just keep doing what we have to do.
When I arrived, right away I could feel so much God's love. So God is really alive. I mean, He's alive. Yeah, anyway, but He's present here and we can feel it. Yeah, this is really tangible. So Heavenly Parents' love, yeah, true parents' love is here. Yeah, and I wish just in the future it would be more possible for more sisters from our region to experience this because so far, because of all these visas. And yeah, problems that very few sisters could ever come. Yeah, just this kind of conference. That I feel, I hope that for our region this could be also possible. Yes, and please know that we will just do our best and keep praying for peace. And I just, my only hope, biggest hope, is through Parents Victorious Foundation. And I believe that because of this Victorious Foundation, God, so this world won't be destroyed by nuclear weapon or whatever. Yeah, and we will live, and our children will live. And there will be peace, and also God's truth can be revealed in all the situations. No lies, only truth, whatever from God's viewpoint.
Yes. I'm really a bit kind of down on earth, so I'm sorry. I will
Well, just to remember that all the PowerPoint that was presented on the first session can be available on this Google Drive, right? So if you want to feel inspired by all the different presentations, that's also one point, right? And on the second session, I would say that all the leaders of the different sessions should really write down all the kind of propositions according to the theme or the action steps that have been discussing about, you know. Of course, they have been reported, but they still need to write it down, and then we have to read it again and really empower ourselves with it. Yeah? For example, in the session where I was, I wanted to share it. In the session where I was in about environmental, so we spoke about recycling, I think. But just my first surprise was, sorry to say that, well, we have a lot of plastic dishes.
Yeah, me too.
So I'm sorry that I said, oh wow, I mean, we have also a lot of plastic dishes here. Mm-hmm. No, I mean, I mentioned that to Isabel, Elizabeth. This is just a step, but we have to say it, but we have to also go forward with it, you know, we have to. So, it means sometimes we need to invest a dishwasher, but maybe it's worthy for the future. That's what I mean. Mm-hmm. No, it's just an example, but just because I was in this session. But it's true, we need to kind of empower all these things and see if it's right. Okay, this is a step forward. And then after we have then, I was very impressed also by the young professionals, and I think the idea of this, form, that's right, of this form, is very good to be able to include some more young people. So I think I personally feel I should try, even in my own country, to do that, to have this form. Especially for second gen, sometimes they have difficulties to get in because they are afraid to be overwhelmed with the work they have, with this, even though they have the desire. So if they have a date limit or if they have a time period, they may feel, okay, it's only for 3 months, for 6 months, maybe I can invest during this time, but they know there is a way to get out afterwards. I mean, this is one way, and if they feel inspired, they would like to stay longer or something. But I found this is something that we can also find in a Google Drive, right?
We will have a meeting and we decide what to do.
Okay, and then can be translated in different countries, different languages for different countries. And then, of course, the social media, thank you very much, Lily, because you do also a lot of work and also leave this for all the social media. And also, it's just, you know, bring me also personal reflection, and I think to everyone of us, how we can improve on, you know, how to sell ourselves or how to promote ourselves more, you know, in the society. And really also about the curriculum. So it was also always my question, you know, how we can get it. We already translated a part of it in French, but still always I would say, please hold on. So I say, okay, hold on, but nothing is coming. So, but now I realize that still we can, somehow, if I ask the link, then we can start. And the best is to start and to see how we can be improved. And I think the curriculum is good to start with it. For those who want to have the link, they can ask. Yeah, think this.
Yeah, so.
So
we received a curriculum, I think 2 years ago, I received it from European office, maybe Anne Schaffner. Is this the old version?
Yes, old version. So you need the latest version, you have to ask for the link.
You have to give us a week or two to compile. Yeah. And
just to make it clear for
them. We send it out as soon as we...
And the guidelines.
And the guidelines, but I mean with the curriculum, you have to, in the end, go on the website and fill in the form, and then you will get it.
And of course, your humanitarian project we share about Ukraine, which has been wonderful to try to continue with the Ukrainian project. And it's also important to involve with a motherly heart, to support wherever also. In different conflicts, and of course the 1% love share, because still North and South Korea needs also to be united, so this is a very important point. So I will try to invest more in the 1% love share and see as a European project how we can, I will try to connect with Korea and find more in Korea how they are doing it, yes, and what we can, what the money that we are collecting with the 1% love share, where they will go, where this money will go. Yeah. Only one thing I heard, that we shouldn't, they don't want to send us pictures because to protect the North Korean refugees, something like this, I want to say. Yeah, and then of course this morning about this membership form, and then thank you very much with this, because we need to feel that we are able to reach that goal. So anyway, everyone, but it's very important that every country find a way to increase the membership. Because every time I'm asked question, how many members you are, you know, I mean, in every association have a certain number of members, and this is how you feel you are important or not so important. If you say 30 members, then you are. So we need to really try to increase our membership as much as we can, not only for the money sake, but also for the public. Yeah.
And also know those with that membership, how who you are reaching out, how many you are reaching out. So you have to keep statistics for yourself, so you know.
For example, just an example, I managed to do it through the website. And there is a different categories. In this website, this is a platform where people can become a member. And the one from Morocco, she sent a membership, you know. Maybe student, 10 euro, you know. Basically, student is for 10 euro. 20 euro supporter, 60 euro active, 100 euro maybe donors and more. So they can sign, you know, they can do with this platform. I'm sure every country has a platform where association can, people can become, I mean, I don't know how to explain, but this is a special platform that we use, where they can also become members.
What's the name?
It's called Hello Asso. Hello Asso. Hello. Association. Hello Asso. Maybe you can find in your countries, I don't know. And then financial situation we will improve. And also we spoke together about where we want to have this a big meeting this year. So we are still seeking, but Armenia was one of the proposition. But maybe some more may come, but just to have in mind, yeah, that we will have something in the end of the year. Armenia, maybe. So that's it. So anyway, personally, time is passing by. I want to give you the time. I want to just to say thank you to every one of you, and I was really glad to come and to also Mitty and Elisabetta and all your team, and it was really great to be here and to learn from everyone of you. Thank you very much.
If Mitya wants to say the last word,
yes.
The last, of course, the last. I want to say also thank you. It was really inspiring. So much life, so strong woman on one place. Really nice.
Hi everybody, yeah, thank you so much. What can I say? You said everything. Yeah, I am a very firm believer the more we meet, the deeper, like the masses of the deeper we get, and the more we gel together. I just think it needs to integrate the younger generation, because we have a wealth of experience. Just so that these 3 points that I follow, that True Mother's Direct, I really love them, because I just think there's fortune in what she says. So, of course, advocacy work, reach out, create the environment, raise the future. Everything she says there. Of course, she's given metaphors about the magnets, and I think that came throughout the whole, what is it? Is it a conference or is it a working? Oh, that's my husband.
Yeah. He feels something.
Yeah, maybe
men. Welcoming, and I just felt, you know, a blessing just to meet her. I just kept in touch with her, and then eventually she moved to Italy, and she became the ambassador here for a while. And now, after a period of time, I don't know how long is it, she'd gone to the Vatican, an ambassador there, inside the Vatican, sitting next to the Pope. December, I really felt really strongly because she's been in my life and she's been to Korea, she knows Japan, she knows everything. So she's been in and out of my life for a while. And when I just felt in December, just ask her outrightly, can you host us? Like, I have a Women of Faith conference in the Vatican. She was quite inspired because I thought, oh, you can't ask people like that. But I thought, just do it, be courageous and do it. You know, why are you hesitating? So then for some reason the universe brought us here, you know? And then I said to her that I'm coming to Italy, maybe we can continue our conversation. She said, come to my restaurant, have lunch with me, you know. And then now she just spoke, make sure I'm all right. And Amanda's taking me, and so I just feel I would really like that. So if you could keep it in your prayers,
absolutely.
I really, if we could get mother there. Sometimes we have to represent through mother. Another thing.
Tell her mother's coming to you.
Maybe it might be a possibility. You know? Just put it in May when mother is there.
What is her name? What was her name?
Her name's Maria Efrenova. So you see, I'm a very thing about, even in the background, just taking care of people. Just now and then. Synergy, you know, time is right now. And I was thinking, whatever public work we do, especially mother is coming, we shouldn't be fearful. Like I'm going to be speaking in the parliament, so I'll let everyone else speak and I'll just be in the background. But I thought, no, this time I have to go in the front and speak up, you know, because mother is coming, so I want to make a condition. And I say to Elizabeth as well, you know, you speak when you're speaking in Europe, like a condition for a true mother. So I think if you can think like that, you know. We're pulled into some environment that is just, you know, the condition for mother. She's going to be here with us soon. And look out for those righteous people that she's saying to ask him. Be those magnets, actually. Also, I forgot to mention in my PowerPoint that I'm looking for two young vice presidents for Europe. I'm not going to be in this position forever. So during that time, I want to find two presidents, vice president. I'm keeping Bridget, so I have three, but I'd like to find two, so we can raise them up and be ready to take the helm. So that is also important. If you have any inspiration, you feel, you can just let me know. You can get them to sign this form. I want to thank everyone.
everybody, you know, the little organizing team, we had a group of us, about four or five of us, but I'm so grateful. You know, it really is teamwork, dream work. And then even Mike says that teamwork is God's team, is it?
God's winning team.
So I think we can inherit that from Mike. And also I reported to Mike that we're coming and he was in Korea. He says, yes, I'll pray for you. You know, so I really felt this. Please, when you go back, meet up with your teams and share with them your experience. Because I think it's really important you don't keep it. Share it with them out and then share the blessings. So I think we had some really deep experiences. And, you know, we do have these conflicts in Europe and they are very sensitive. There's a lot of tears there as well. And it kind of brings you home. You know, people are suffering and we have to find a way to comfort them. Find a solution. That's also why I want to really think about the Bridge of Peace, because I don't think it's been utilized enough. I really want to use this forgiveness program and reconciliation, and step by step, how do you do it? How do you forgive your enemy? And it has to be very practical, you know. So this will be one of my goals to find a way. And if you base, again, I must mention, based on True Father's words of how he overcame. How he could love his enemy in the prison and without words but with service. Yeah. So, yeah, thank you so much, everyone. I will have to rush because somebody's waiting for me.
And I can learn a lot and to do things without fear, what we could not do so far. This is also my goal. And I think, I hope we stay young with this thinking mindset.
Yes.
Also, applause for Victor because hard job to.
My pleasure.
Yeah. And she has to go back to so much snow, so we sympathize.
And especially for our young ones.
Messages and informations and inspirations from around the European, around the world. A big applause for all the participants. Along and like here we can overcome frustrations and irritations quite quick and also some technical
maybe Carmen
would be nice to
hear. Where is Carmen?
Carmen is over there. We've got a youth team.
On an international level, but also on a national level. have to meet all these fantastic and amazing women. All the work that has been done through the Women's Federation. And when I came here, I was talking in the morning. When I came here, I didn't know what to expect because I haven't been in any Women's Federation event on this level like this. And so it was really interesting to see like that we really have all these women around us that are working and striving to make a better world, and to see that True Mother founded this, and we have all these people like still working and investing. So it's really an inspiration, and I hope I can also contribute more and more to the Women's Federation in Portugal and in Europe, and hopefully in the world. Popcorn.
No sisters.